Hey, this is Warren Redlich. I just wanted to talk a little bit about how Tesla is worth trillions of dollars. Even the bull cases that you're seeing people talking about are underestimates of where Tesla can go if you look at the numbers. And I'm going to just break down some really simple numbers for you that I think explain why Tesla is worth trillions of dollars. Imagine a robotaxi world. Tesla's plan going forward is, number one, to dramatically increase battery production. And if they're able to dramatically increase battery production, even without self-driving cars, they're going to be able to sell enough cars, they're making enough margin that the company is worth what it's worth right now. They're going to sell millions and millions of cars. They're making a lot of money on each car in the long haul at the pace they're going. So that's great. But the real bull case for Tesla depends on self-driving cars. And a robotaxi network is something that they've talked about. And that's a compelling case for why Tesla is worth so much money. And I've said to people before, oh, the cost of a Tesla Model 3 once they have self-driving is going to go up to over $100,000. And people think I'm crazy. Well, let's take a look at this. Imagine a simple Tesla Model 3 or Model Y. They're about the same for this purpose. Put it in a robotaxi network. Suppose it makes $1 a mile. And it drives for a million miles. The price is $1 a mile, and it drives for a million miles. Now, that's an optimist scenario for a million miles, but just bear with me for a minute. Keep in mind, Elon Musk has said they're working on delivering a million-mile battery. It requires 4,000 cycles. They've done it in other contexts. It's pretty reasonable. And I know it's optimistic, but it's a reasonable optimism to say they're going to deliver a 1-million-mile car. There is a 2013 Tesla Model S in Europe that has already done 600,000 miles. I think we're going to see this happen. So take that Tesla Model 3 or Model Y, a million miles, $1 a mile. And where am I getting $1 a mile from? Uber costs $2 to $2.50, maybe $3 a mile, depending on circumstances. So it's reasonable to assume that a Tesla robotaxi will be able to get and sustain $1 a mile. At a million miles, that's $1 million in revenue. Now, what's the cost per mile for that Tesla Model 3 or Model Y? Tesloop, which is a company that operates Teslas in a almost robo-taxi-like way in California, estimates their cost for the Model 3 at 18 to 25 cents a mile, including depreciation. Now, I'm leaving depreciation out of it, and I say, let's say it's 25 cents a mile. Now you're talking about 75 cents a mile in profit for a million miles. That means each Tesla Model 3 or Model Y will generate $750,000 in profit. Okay, that's pretty good. Now, say I'm overestimating. Say the cost of operating the car is really 40 cents a mile. Say that you're really only going to get 90 cents a mile on average for driving the car. That's still 50 cents a mile times a million miles is $500,000 in profit per car. Multiply that by 10 million cars. I don't mean 10 million cars a year. I mean, let's say reasonably, again, I don't think this is an extremely optimistic scenario. Reasonably, let's say Tesla is going to make 10 million cars over the course of, let's say, the next 10 or 20 years. 10 million times $500,000 is $5 trillion in profit. Let me take a step back. Skip out the whole Tesla is selling cars. Tesla just produces the cars and runs the robotaxi network itself. This makes everything simple. We're not worrying about transactions costs. We're not worrying about whether you have to have a dealership or not. We're not, you know, Tesla owns the cars themselves. So their cost of maintenance is going to be less than your or my cost of maintenance would be because they're handling everything. Tesla, if they just build themselves 10 million cars and run a robotaxi network, Tesla will make $5 trillion in profit on 10 million cars. Now, I think I'm being conservative. I think that Tesla could easily make more than 10 million cars. I think Tesla could make more than 50 cents a mile in profit on these cars. I think the million miles is probably reasonable. Maybe that's optimistic. But even if I'm overstating it and you cut my numbers here and there, you're still getting $1 trillion in profit if you cut a lot of my estimates. And I think I'm being reasonable when I say $5 trillion in profits. Now, I like to go further in the future. I like to think, where does this go in the long run? And I said in a previous video that the long run, the goal is to get to 5 cents a mile or 10 cents a mile, because that radically changes our world. Even 10 cents a mile radically changes our world, but 5 cents a mile radically changes our world. So I put together one scenario with, in my previous video, I talked about the $10,000 made in China Tesla Robotaxi, which is simply a smaller Tesla that is designed from the get-go for Robotaxi work. So there's no steering wheel, there's no windshield wipers. You save a lot of money on making the car. The car is lighter weight, the car is hyper efficient. And in that scenario, you can sustain really high profits at just 50 cents a mile. That's one step along the way, is getting it down to 50 cents a mile. And now it's a much lighter weight car. It's not as heavy as a Tesla Model 3 or Model Y. The cost of manufacturing is going to be a lot less because you're skipping some steps, and the car doesn't need to be as sturdy if the robo-taxi network is safe. If robo-taxis are inherently safer than human drivers, and a lot safer than human drivers, then you can make them lighter weight. You don't need the same structural integrity that you have in these super-duper Model 3s and Model Ys. And so at a 50 cent a mile pricing scenario, if you get that vehicle down to 10 or 15 cents a mile, and you do 1 million miles, now again, you're making, let's say, 35 cents a mile times 1 million miles, you're still making a ridiculous amount of money. $350,000 a car for a much less expensive car. Tesla is able to make more of the cars because they require less resources for each car. Maybe they only need 2/5 the battery pack to sustain it. Now you take it one step further into the future, and you talk about the pod car. And the pod car is designed for one person only, and it's much smaller. Maybe it's 3 feet wide, and it's 6 or 7 feet long. Takes up half the horizontal space on the roadway, takes up half the front-to-back space on the roadway. The roadway can now accommodate four times as many cars. Add into that the robo-taxis now start communicating with each other, you can reduce following distance, and now road capacity increases another 2x, and you have 8x the capacity on the roads. Which is important, because if you lower the cost of transportation as much as I'm talking about here, people are going to take more trips. You lower the price of something, people will use more of it. But now you're down to these pod cars. And basically they're like really small golf carts designed for one passenger. Something like 80% of trips have only one passenger in the vehicle. You get down to this world where you have these pod cars that are even more efficient, even less expensive to build. Maybe it costs $5,000 to build one of these things. Maybe it uses 1/5 the battery pack of a Tesla Model 3 or Model Y. So it's got a 10 kilowatt hour battery pack. But because it's carrying so much less weight, it becomes that much more efficient. It uses electricity that much more efficiently, so we can go a lot farther on that battery pack than you would expect without having a larger battery pack. Now at that level, let's say you're only making a nickel a mile in profit. You're charging 10 cents a mile and it costs 5 cents a mile, but it goes 1 million miles. Well, 10 cents times 1 million miles is $100,000 in profit on a car that only costs $5,000 to make. So again, you're seeing Tesla make, and you're making a lot more of these because, again, the cost of making these is a lot less. There's a huge demand, and you're going to see even bigger numbers. But if you make 100 million of them, you're back to your huge amount of money. If you put all this together, if you imagine Tesla earning $5 trillion in profit, even $1 trillion in profit over the next 10 years, and let's say this starts in 4 years. But over that next 10-year stretch, Tesla makes $1 trillion in profit. What is that company worth? What would you pay to buy a company that's going to produce $1 trillion in profit in 10 years? Well, you'd pay at least $1 trillion for it, because it's going to continue making profits after that. So Tesla is worth, on the bull scenario, they deliver full self-driving, they execute, they deliver the battery production. You are talking about a company that is worth so dramatically more than what the price you're seeing today. People are talking about Tesla at $1,000 a share, $150 billion market cap. We're talking about a $10 trillion market cap. We're talking about nearly a 50x increase in the share price. It's not gonna be a $10,000 share price for Tesla. It's gonna be a $50,000 share price for Tesla. Tesla is worth $50,000 a share. In the bull case of everything going well with self-driving cars and battery production, and execution. Now, with all that said, there's one thing that could screw this up. Government. The first thing that any politician's going to see when they see this new $1 trillion revenue machine is how can we tax it? And the one thing you need to understand is when you see some politician say, we only need to tax them a penny a mile, we only need to tax them 10 cents a mile, they're cutting into your freedom. They're cutting into your ability to travel. They're cutting the ability, they're cutting into the potential for this technology to make our world a better place. If you study economics, and I have, there's this concept of transactions costs, that one of the big impediments, one of the big thing that impairs economic efficiency, that makes our economy work not as well, is when you have high transactions costs. And it's one of the things that in economic theory that government can do to make the economy work better is to reduce transactions costs. And what we see consistently throughout our society, throughout our economy, is government finding ways to increase transactions costs. They make things cost more, whether it's sales tax, property tax, mortgage taxes, everything. We constantly see government finding ways to increase our transactions costs and make our economy work worse. So be on the lookout for this. As the self-driving car becomes a reality, as the Robotaxi network becomes a reality, you are going to hear government officials cry at their loss of revenue from gas taxes. They're going to find a way to justify to you that they need money for something. And what they are telling you is they want to cut into your freedom to travel. They want to prevent a change that is going to make our world a better place. These robo-taxis are going to reduce CO2 emissions, and whether you believe in climate change or not, they're going to reduce all kinds of other pollution. They're going to reduce traffic accidents and make our lives safer. They're going to eliminate 30,000 deaths a year in America and millions around the world. This is a tremendous technology change that's going to make our lives better, and the one thing that can screw it up is politicians looking for a way they can suck out our money and ruin it for all of us. I'm optimistic that you will pay attention to that last part of this video, that you will tell your friends, and when you hear a politician talking about how we need to tax self-driving cars, we need to tax robo-taxis, that you will speak up, you will say no, you will grab that politician, you will say no, you are not going to ruin our economy, you're not going to stop this improvement to our lives. Stop it. You can do it. And that will make our world a better place. It's already wonderful. We already live in one of the best times, and the best time we've ever had. It's going to get better. Let's enjoy. Even if the politicians try to screw it up, it'll still be good. Even if they manage to get a toehold in there somewhere, it's still going to be great. Our lives are still going to be better. But fight for it. Thank you very much. This is Warren Redlich.